This is leaving the National Rocky Mountain National Park about 7:30 at night. We spent about 2 to 3 hours up there today. Showing you a house on the hill. Whoops, can't focus that far. It's right up here. This is my pointer, like a school teacher, right up there on the hill. Is this coming into Estes Park here?
Yeah, but I don't know where from where.
Okay.
You just have to.
Yeah, with a navigator pilot. At this point, we don't know pilot and navigator which way we're coming in. Just as far. So if we don't tell the girls, no one's gonna panic.
I want to go on that big glass side, Grandpa.
Jake just saw this house on the hill about right there. Oh. That's a tram.
We didn't bring the sack of the breads and stuff in the cup. Careful, boss.
I'm just going to use this one. Cigarette ash.
Cigarette ash? Here, here's one here. Come here, there.
Got some big horns on that one.
Oh, you got the binoculars. Okay, Jeff. Can you see them?
The grandpa used binoculars for a second. Like Grandpa used binoculars.
You can't hardly see them. They're kind of down in the in the water.
Water hole.
Just for a second. Yes, he does.
All you can see is her tail sticking up.
Here you go.
Park ranger.
Where's the policeman?
There.
Got big horn. That one's walking this way. You seen the big horns on them? That thing,
binoculars, Mom?
2 foot long.
Honey, you do not need any more. You just had two glasses. We're not gonna. Here, put your glasses on, please.
I need the binoculars.
You can look through the binoculars with your glasses on. That'll help you see better. I'll show you how. Put your glasses on. All you do is put them up there like that, just the same as you do without glasses on.
Morning. Hurry up.
This is,
morning.
Hey, sweetie, here.
August 5th.
It's your 25th.
Yep. Monday.
Hold on, see chipmunks.
Here we go.
Grandpa! It's a waste day. I can hear the water. Can you hear it? I can't even hear
morning,
the water.
Morning, Brandon.
Okie dokie,
Mokie. Can you hear the waterfall?
Uh-huh. Camera.
Oh, look, this is
We're at the Andover. Andover Valley. At 9:24 in the morning. Jake, she's not feeling too good this morning. Hopefully that's going to clear up real quick. That kind of rough night. Hold Mama's hand. You doing okay?
Doing fine.
I'll lift you down.
Can I walk over on that river?
Huh?
I'm going to walk over there by the park by the man.
They're down here by where we live. Where's your peanut?
They're by the camera. Have to go climb over the logs.
Oh.
You're okay. Just ask Mama to hold your hand.
Coming or not?
Yes!
Okay, well, I'll wait for you then if you're coming. Just walk on the tree stumps. Come on, you can do it.
There's water.
Well, sure, there's water. If you fall in, you're not going very far.
Mama, you have to help me to watch the dog.
Hold your hands out.
Here. Just walk on the tree stumps there. Come on. See, now this log moves, so just a minute here, okay? Let me turn around. You don't want Mama to go for it? You go ahead and walk on. Walk into that big stone. Don't let anyone know it. Go. Ah! Walk sideways. You gotta go now, dude.
Little Boy Scout training here. Success. There's a grandma, grandpa, and Brandon are in the woods somewhere there. We'll go down there and I spotted them. Way up there. Let's see if I can manually zoom. Here they come. Oh, okay. Justin wants to throw rocks in there to make a sidewalk across the stream. I guess he's got a little beaver in him.
And here comes the other three. Horseshoe waterfalls are right up there. This is where they had their flood. Notice that the trees are barren, most of them. Notice lots of rock. And way up there you can see a lot more rock. I guess that's from where the waters came down and pushed the rock down. Everybody's getting out, so we're gonna go ahead and turn this over to the expert cameraman right here, Mr. Chan.
Million gallons of water pounded down from the 5 mile length of roaring river. The water dropped trees like matches, tossed boulders like playthings, and filled the air with its awful roar. This was in July 15th, 1982. Notice the sparkle in the rocks.
Isn't that neat rock? You see that little indention in it over here?
Uh-huh. Got a sparkle in it.
Uh-huh. It's pretty over here on this side with the sunshine. Across the river.
We'll just survey the area. of all the rocks that it brought down with it. And killed all the trees. Uh-oh, got a moonwalker. Gallons of water in a couple hours during the flood. I want to correct myself, it was 300 million gallons of water. I misread it the first time. That's what it said, the roar and the... Now you can...
I think this is mountain. This is the gentle little waterfall that Jeff and I climbed over.
Used to be a little waterfall.
Yeah, this is it. Beyond Jeff.
Yeah, because you come down there and...
That's the gentle little valley we used to be in. Because you guys wandered all over down there while we climbed. That's the highway up there, you watch home. You can catch a car. Go along. Let's see what. Not much traffic today.
Not as much as yesterday,
probably. It's Monday, not Sunday.
Okay.
Oh, no, wait. Back here.
I can see Diana and Justin in the background over there.
Go ahead, it's video.
Yeah, I do too. I wanted to get the roar.
Here's the bird, it's a blue jay. And right there. Sit down, Brandon. Sit down.
Up on a pass here, and this morning we were right down there. We'll zoom in, that's where the flood was. That's where all the boulders, as it came down.
Are you crippled? You're in a wheelchair?
Jesus Christ!
Lots of rocks. Down here in this valley, like Jake said, there are some sheep down there. Notice some cars are parked down there. kind of a scenic view right there. See a bird. Oops, missed it. There's a stream right there. I don't think there's any sheep. Can't see any through the viewfinder. Real pretty. Elevation's about 9,000 right now. This is another view of where the stream went down, the flood. I think 30 million gallons goes down there a day. I think Charles already highlighted that. Just ripped it right out of the forest. Real pretty. And that was the trip that we took up yesterday to the 12,000 foot elevation. Notice the roads kind of crisscross there. And we finally end up there, behind there. It was quite a long trip. Here's one of those birds. Hopefully you can hear it. They've been looking for. Big long tail. I think it's looking back. See who's gonna feed it. Where the cars are parked?
Yeah, well, just to the right of that, that's that big elk horn crossing. Where they come across the road?
Yeah. Down here is the big horn elk crossing. That's where we saw some this morning down in the field. And yesterday we saw some up in the mountains there coming down.
There's a big elk version.
Yeah, I already caught it. Here we have our youngest 2-year-old driver driving up here about 8,500 feet. Hi, Brandon, you gonna wave? Are you driving? Because there's Grandpa, he passed out from the height. So we put Brandon in his place. Keep your eyes on the road. Look ahead of you. Yes? Okay. And let me see. Jake and Dinah went to this place called the Spruce House. Christmas place. And Charles and I are not too worried about this place. Because before the girls went in, we took their plastic cards away. And you can see Santa Claus there. If you look inside, you can see a
Christmas trees right there, decorations. And that's the front there.